Well, pop those corks and pop your sunnies on. We're crossing to Bris Vegas now, where the always colourful Craig Bennett is raring to unleash his fabulousness with his latest showbiz countdown. Craigie B, what are you ranking for us today?
Hello, Ange. Well, you know what? I thought we would count down those Hollywood serial brides and grooms. The stars who, well, it seems, can't get enough of the confetti. Oh, my gosh, look at this. Or the wedding cake. Or husbands and wives. So, question first, Ange. What do Billy Joel, Jennifer Lopez, Doris Day, Frank Sinatra, Liza Minnelli, oh, and Melanie Griffith have in common? Four marriages.
Four.
And if you think that is an extravagant flutter of confetti like what's just hailing down on me at the moment, way too much wedding cake. Well, as Al Jolson said in The Jazz Singer, and that was back in 1927, you ain't heard nothing yet. So this is my 6-to-1 of those multi-married Hollywood stars, those celebs who seem to have I Do on repeat.
Well, the scene is set. Who is in at number 6?
Well, normally, Ange, as you know, this would be my 8-to-1, but today it's 6-to-1. Now, not being a cheapskate, I want to point this out. It's just that there are so many stars who can't say I don't that we'd be here all day. So, coming in at number 6 is Dame Joan Collins. Now, Dame Joan has whirled down the aisle, what is it, 5 times. She claims she married her first hubby, who was Irish actor Maxwell Reed, after he raped her. Now, her second hubby was singer-songwriter Anthony Newley, the wonderful Anthony Newley. She then married a businessman who had this raging drug problem. Then she wed much younger Swedish pop sensation Peter Holm, who she branded a money-grubbing philanderer. She then found her happily ever after, I'm thrilled to say, and we're looking at them there, hubby number 5, her Percy. Percy Gibson, who is 31 years Dame Joan's junior, but they've been married 20 years now. And to think that there were some who said, ah, it'll never last. Now, other stars who've notched up 5 marriage go-rounds include the late great country crooner Kenny Rogers, Nicolas Cage is in that mix with 5 troops down the aisle, and the sultry Hollywood siren so loved from that movie Gilda, Rita Hayworth.
Well, your number 5 features a golden girl as well as a former bikini-clad TV sex symbol.
Oh, absolutely, indeedy, doody, wordy. Now, it's Golden Girls star Rue McClanahan. Rue, of course, played man-eating Southern belle Blanche Devereaux on The Golden Girls. And for a bit of a walk down memory lane, a bit of a waft into nostalgia land, here is some classic Rue as Blanche.
Oh, I do love the rain, so it reminds me of my first kiss.
Your first kiss was in the rain.
No, it was in the shower.
We don't want to keep our dates waiting.
Wait, Blanche, honey, aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, no, I never wear underwear.
How about some whipped cream?
I think we still have a can. I'll get it. It's in my bedroom.
Never mind, Blanche.
I hate phone calls in the middle of the night. Now I'll never get back to sleep. I'm as jumpy as a virgin at a prison rodeo.
Oh, my gosh, the gloriousness of Blanche Elizabeth Devereaux. Yes. Did you note her initials spell bed? Blanche Elizabeth Devereaux. And she boasted throughout the course of the show that she had 143 lovers, not that she was counting, and 3 marriage proposals. But in real life, I tell you what, Rue McClanahan had 6 hubbies. Now, amongst her 6 grooms were several actors. There was a Greek-American real estate agent. Now, her 5th hubby was actually her high school boyfriend, so that was a recycled romance, which I have to say turned really rather sour very quickly. And according to Rue, he romped away with a huge chunk of her Golden Girls money, so a bit of Rue-rude there. Now, Ruth's 6th hubby was actor Morrow Wilson, but really sad story because she kicked him out after she'd suffered this debilitating stroke because she didn't want him to see her paralysed and unable to speak and so forth. 6 weddings was also the charm, or otherwise, for Billy Bob Thornton, whose wives included, I'm sure you recall vividly, Angelina Jolie. Now, that was a wild pair. When they were together, the vials of blood and the really crazy sex life that they never stopped talking about. For those wondering, Billy Bob is currently married to a makeup artist. And the sex bomb you were talking about, referring to Ange, Pamela Anderson, who has also enjoyed 6 marriages and 6 divorces. Now, her 5th marriage was to Hollywood mover and shaker John Peters. It barely lasted a weekend. More recently, she was married to and then divorced from her handyman. Now, number 4 is late comedy king Richard Pryor, who staggered down the aisle 7 times. His wife, Tally, though, was 5, as he married 2 of his wives twice. Yep. Now, his widow, Jennifer Lee, was actually at one point in time his interior decorator. She was his 5th and 7th wife. Richard revealed the reason for his smorgasbord of marriages and wives. Well, it came down to 2 things. His tumultuous early upbringing, which really was. His mother was an alcoholic lady of the night, as they used to say in the old days. A hooker or a lady with rounded heels. I remember my auntie when used to refer to such people as. She abandoned Richard when he was 10. So he wound up being brought up by his grandma, who ran a brothel. Richard claimed he was sexually abused as a kid, all of which he said impacted him later when he became a drunk and a drug addict, wildly freebasing cocaine and at one point setting himself on fire, you might recall. And this led to a hurdy-gurdy life of affairs, abuse and, as we now know, 7 marriages. Look, we're up to number 3. You know, sometimes the confetti doesn't flutter where it's meant to. Anyway, we're up to number 3 and the honour of notching up 8 marriages goes to Hollywood movie queen and serial bride extraordinaire Elizabeth Taylor. But she's not alone, as talk show royalty Larry King, the late great Larry King, he of The Suspenders, married 8 times as well, as did Mickey Rooney and Lana Turner. Well, La Liz toted up 7 hubbies but 8 marriages as she wed Richard Dickie Burton twice. Now, along with an array of movers and shakers and politicians, her last hubby was construction worker Larry Fetensky. Now, they met in rehab at the Betty Ford Centre. She was addicted to pills. He was addicted to beer. Larry was decades younger. She called him Larry the Lion because he had this impressive mane of flowing hair. In 1991, there was the wedding of the century at Michael Jackson's Neverland Ranch. Look at them there. Liza Minnelli warbled, Michael walked La Liz down the aisle, and Bubbles the Chimp was on the guest list. Of course, you'd be mad not to have Bubbles the Chimp on the guest list. The marriage lasted 5 years. Now, after Elizabeth's death, Larry's life spiralled into a terrible pit of despair. He fell down the stairs after grieving the death of his pet ferret and was actually in a coma for 6 weeks. Sadly, he's left us now. And talking of Elizabeth Taylor and her 8 weddings, how's this for a wonderful quote from La Liz? She once quipped, "I'm a very committed wife and I should be committed too for being married so many times." There you go. But she's far from the most married bride in La La Land.
Mm. Oh, wow. Now, Craig, moving on, your number 2 is related to Paris Hilton.
Yeah. I know. Join the dots on this one, Abo. Yes, it's Zsa Zsa Gabor, famous for being famous long before Paris was famous for being famous. And there is a connection, you see, as Paris Hilton's great-grandfather, the Hilton Hotel magnate Conrad Hilton, was one of Zsa Zsa's husbands. Now, Conrad's son, Nicky Hilton, was one of Elizabeth Taylor's husbands. I tell you what, you need a whiteboard, a roadmap, a tracker dog and a cut lunch to follow all of this, don't you? Anyway, back to Zsa Zsa Gabor. She had 9 husbands. Now, among them was the actor George Sanders. Zsa Zsa's 9th hubby was Prince Frederick von Anhalt, who wasn't really a prince. I think he kind of bought the title or found it in a box of cornflakes or something. Anyway, for her 25th wedding anniversary, there they are, the lovebirds, Prince Freddie and Zsa Zsa. For their 25th wedding anniversary, he bought her a billboard in Los Angeles for $68,000 that said, "Happy Anniversary, Zsa Zsa." He hosted this very swanky party, awash with celebrities in some fabulous hotel, but Zsa Zsa was too ill to attend, so she was at home in bed with a wig on, her teeth in, swathed in a pink nightie, watching the whole thing unfold on television. The wedding lasted 30 years until her death in 2016, by which point she'd reached the grand age of 99. Now, Zsa Zsa had two sisters, Ava Gabor. Remember Greenacres? She was Lisa Douglas making the hotcakes in Greenacres. The other sister was actress Magda. We don't know her as well as we did Ava, who was married. Magda, by the way, was married to George Sanders. So you had Zsa Zsa married to George Sanders and her sister Magda also married to George Sanders. Between the three Gabor sisters, they were married 20 times. Now, Zsa Zsa 9, Magda 6, and Ava Gabor 5. I got to tell you, that's a lot of confetti. No wonder there's no trees left in the Amazon basin.
Glitter cannons are now at the ready. Confetti is ready to go as well. Who is the most married showbiz star, Craig
B? My gosh, I'm throwing some confetti your way. There you go. It's somebody I bet you've never heard of. He was, however, a big Western movie star of the 40s and 50s. Now, his name is Alfred or Al Lash LaRue. He was dubbed the King of the Bullwhip, and the reason was because he had this 5-metre bullwhip that he'd whip through his movies. He starred in such Western classics as Song of Old Wyoming and The Son of Billy the Kid. He was renowned not just for his movies and the bullwhip, but for whipping down the aisle again, and then through the divorce courts in between the marriages. You see, Al Lash LaRue married and divorced at least 10 times, maybe a dozen, right? No one is really sure. And even Al lost track because, well, he was such a boozer, by his own admission, his mind was often an alcoholic mush. And he just couldn't remember. Here for those thinking Craig Bennett is making all this up despite the fact you're seeing Al Lash LaRue there on your screen. Here is Al talking to Entertainment Tonight around about 35 years ago.
Arrests, vagrancy, many marriages. What happened to you?
Well, I guess I just didn't think fast enough to stay out of trouble. I never had an idea that I was getting into trouble when I was getting into trouble.
How many times were you married?
More than once. And that was a mistake.
More than once, and that was a mistake. Too many knocks to the head with all that confetti, I say. Very sadly, Al Lash LaRue died in 1996, and fabulous Sarah and wonderful Beau, that is my countdown done and dusted for another day, and I'm now off to hop into a great big slice of somebody else's wedding cake.
Oh, snap your garter while you're at it, Craigie. We'll see you soon.
Well done, mate.